Joe, thanks for being with us. Let me ask you first about what drew you to the diaconate program here in the Diocese of Scranton.
Right. Being a person of Christian faith, it really brings me peace of mind and peace of heart. It helps me to understand a little bit what I think what God's purpose for me is. And being able to be involved in the diaconate program brought me to a better and deeper understanding of that. And I feel that as an ordained deacon, I think I'll have more opportunity to help other people find relevance with the church in their lives.
Talk to me about the program itself. Did you find yourself growing in spirituality?
Very much so, very much so. The program itself is designed to really draw you into so many elements of growth. There's an academic aspect to it that's really wonderful and challenging, but by no means is that all it is. There's elements to it that really help you to reflect and discern as to where your role within the church would be. It's really been a blessing. I've enjoyed all 4.5 years of it so far. We still got ordination coming up this month, as well as homiletics to follow. So I'm going to miss it a lot. It's really been a wonderful blessing in my life.
Way back when, years ago, when you maybe were first exploring it, and you said, years here, did you say, oh, I don't know if this is for me?
I knew early on to savor every moment of it. I really did. So that's really, throughout the whole thing, I've tried to just live in the moment and really enjoy it for what it is, because I knew it would go by quickly, and it sure has. It has gone by quickly.
Now, you're already fully involved in the diocese down at St. Nick's Church in Wilkes-Barre. Talk about your profession, what you do kind of, and how it's going to all fit in with being a deacon.
Yeah, I'm Director of Faith Formation at St. Nick's in Wilkes-Barre. So I've been blessed, as you say, to be able to work in the church for the last few years. So really, I think that becoming a deacon will only enhance that and really just bring further growth and further opportunities for me to reach people. I don't know how much my life will change, but that's part of the excitement.
Being able to be with the priests and the sisters, do they help you grow in a lot of ways?
The priests, the sisters, and the faithful, as much as the priests and the sisters. Being in a vibrant, diverse parish, especially as St. Nick's is, has been a revelation to me. The faithfulness of the people there is something that really sustains me. And the priests and the sisters are great too.
What aspect of ministry are you looking forward to most?
Oh, that's a great question. There are so many elements that are enriching. But I'd have to say that I recently had an experience in RCIA, leading an RCIA group, bringing adults into full communion into the church. That was really powerful for me. We had the shutdown take place towards the end of it, so that added an interesting wrinkle to it. But what struck me was that their faith was never wavered or never diminished throughout it. We ended up switching to online meetings. And then, you know, we still had confirmation just later than we expected. And I really appreciated that whole opportunity, that whole experience. And I'm very much looking forward to, as a deacon, leading more of that. Adult faith formation is really powerful. I love that moment when folks actually see what type of relevance the church can have in their lives. You know, and there's a moment in somebody's journey when you actually see that take place and see that click, and that is so enjoyable.
That teaching that moment where their eyes kind of widen a little bit, and you know they get it. This connects with them.
Right, right. And then to see them grow from there is just a blessing.
Obviously, you can't do this on your own. You're not an island. You have your parish with you, you have your family with you. How important has their support been through this whole process?
The program itself requires that you have the support and help from your parish and your family. My wife, especially. You know, my wife is my partner in everything I do. and this is obviously no exception. This is a huge part of my life. It is my life. It's not a part of my life. And Barbara is I can't even begin to describe how important her support is, as well as my children and my friends. You know, I have so many strong Christian friends who help me and who I think I help too. That's really part of this whole mission that we're on.
As you've been a part of this, is there anything else that's stuck out to you, you know, that you think people should know about?
Yes. People should realize just how great the diaconate program is in the Diocese of Scranton, how well put together it is. There comes a point in your formation in the later years where you realize that everything you've done has built upon what you've learned before. And that's just really a testament to Monsignor Bohr and the other guys and the other priests who have put the program together. From a formation standpoint, it's stellar. So I feel blessed to be able to have gone through it here in Scranton.